first, I'm live at Clipper Mill Pool where I continue my Olympic adventures. And today I try a sport that's basically a mix of so many different sports, basketball, hockey, and even wrestling, all done while treading water. I visit Johns Hopkins University to meet up with coaches and former players to see if I could hang with water polo. To play water polo, you have to wear a special cap to protect your ears from serious injury.
I guess I didn't realize this was such a contact sport.
Oh, you don't understand. We go to the hospital almost every weekend.
That's great to hear.
Well, you're going to be okay.
Thankfully, they promised to go easy on me. Coach Ted started off by explaining the basics of the game. One team tries to make a goal while the other team plays defense.
What we're going to do here is Ava's going to throw Sean McCrary in a pass to 5 meter. Sean will be fouled by Yvonne.
I was learning how to play in the shallow end. Normally, the game is played in at least 2 meters of water.
You're treading the entire game. It's, for a lot of water polo players, you're so used to it, it almost becomes like walking.
Between the start and the finish of the game, they'll be sprinting up to 2 miles.
Then you have to factor in all the defense.
They're virtually wrestling in the water. There's full contact. Like, a lot of people, when they think of water polo, they don't think it's tough until they come see a game.
I think it is the hardest sport. Swimming and wrestling with people, and these aren't small guys. These are 200-pounders, so it's a tough game.
Fortunately, I didn't have to partake in any of the wrestling. All I had to do was throw the ball. And I even got to shoot some goals. I made most of my shots, but only because the goalie went easy on me. So why isn't this sport more prominent in America? Coach Ted says it's gaining popularity, but it takes some time for people to really understand the game.
The intricacy of the whistle, people don't understand why it's start and stop because there's so much fouling going on. And I think that when somebody sees it on TV, they're not understanding what the fouls are. They understand that. They understand the beauty of the game.
And talk about one tough sport. Coach Ted there at Johns Hopkins University said that normally these players can lose anywhere from 2 to 4 pounds in water weight every single game because they're just sweating that much. We'll head back to Tony in the Weather Center. And boy, I give these guys and girls who play the sport a lot of credit. The men will be playing later this afternoon at the Olympics and the women tomorrow.
What makes them so tough is they can't wear any additional pads, right? It's not like hockey where they could put pads on all over the place. And they got contact going on. You can't wear it in the pool because you'll sink, right? I mean, they got the helmets.
From what I could
tell,
the only protection that they are wearing was on their head. So that tells you a lot.
Those are some tough guys right there. Thank you, Ava. Appreciate it.